How's it going, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Junluca, aka Dr. Calcagno, and I am a final year medical resident in family medicine. So I'm actually really, really excited about this video because it's been a while since I went back and took a look at the rankings. But before I get ahead of myself, what we're doing today is going over the top 50 ranked medical schools in the entire world. These are some of the most competitive schools to get into and their rankings and how they compare to each other. This time of year, so it's currently about February, there are many pre-meds going through the process of applying to medical school, and I get a lot of questions from pre-meds this time of year. Which university should I go to? Should I choose this medical school over this medical school? Do rankings matter? Does the fact that this school is ranked slightly lower in certain categories affect whether or not I should go there? And I wanted to do today's video, number one, to go over the updated rankings, but two, just to give my thoughts as a current resident physician as to how rankings impact your decision to go to a certain school. Now for today's video, I'm actually partnering with a company called MotivateMD. Some of you have probably heard about them before. They are a medical school as well as residency application prep company. They'll help with interviews as well as essay writing and application planning. You guys know that I hardly do any sponsors here on the channel, but for sure I don't do them unless I look into them first. And these guys have great reviews. We'll talk more about them later, but we'll get to today's video. So I'm not gonna waste anyone's time. We'll go right to the top 50. Please go ahead, like the video and leave me a comment if you could guess what the top one is. I bet you most people aren't gonna guess what number one is. It's always up in the air. A little bit contentious, we'll get into it as well. But starting with number 50, we have LMU in Munich. Then 49, the University of Manchester in the UK. Kyoto University in Japan is 48. Then we have the Erasmus University in Rotterdam, University of Amsterdam, the Seoul National University in South Korea. Then we have Emory in 44, Yonsei in 43, and I'm very sorry in advance if I'm butchering some of these names. I'm gonna try my best. 42, we have KU. 41, we have Boston. 40, we have Northwestern in the United States as well. Then we have a two-way tie at 38 between the University of Sydney, that's in Australia, at 38, as well as the Fudan University in China. 37, Chinese University of Hong Kong. 36, we have McMaster University, which is actually where I went. And if I was putting this list together, I would put it up much higher. But we'll get back to that in a little bit too. 35, we have the University of Heidelberg. 34, we have the University of British Columbia, which is McMaster. It's like they're our rival when it comes to these ranking systems. We're always right behind or right ahead of each other. 32, another two-way tie. We have the Washington University in St. Louis, as well as the University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill. 31, we have the New York University. Then at 30, the University of Tokyo. At 29, Monash University in Australia. Two-way tie at 27. My German's not the best, but Charité, and it's a French accent. Anyways, University in Berlin. Then we have also at 27, the University of California in San Diego. On the other side of that, we have the University of Chicago at 25, and then Peking University at 24, the University of Edinburgh in the UK at 23, Duke University makes 22, University of Michigan is at 21, then the University of Melbourne back to Australia in 20, University of Hong Kong is 19, University of Washington, 18, another two-way tie at 16 between the University of Singapore and the Karolinska Institute in Sweden. Then at 15, we have the University of California in Los Angeles. We have how I believe is pronounced Tsinghua University in China. Then at 13, we have King's College London. There's a few famous YouTubers that actually came out of King's College. We have Carmen Medic, we have Kenji Medical. There's a few of them from there. And then Columbia is 12. University of California, Berkeley makes 11, and then I will pause before our top 10. So two things I just wanna say before we get into the top 10 is that many people ask me, like, how did these ranking systems work? And why did you choose to go with the Times Higher Education? When it comes to ranking for the medical schools, there's really only two companies that are doing it on a yearly basis and have been trusted in terms of people comparing the different standings of the schools. On the one hand, you have the Times Higher Education Survey, and on the other hand, you have the QS University Rankings that also comes out every single year. The only reason why we've chosen to go with the Times Higher Education today is because they have their 2024 rankings already. QS still only has their 2023 rankings. As for the list itself, each of these schools have been ranked in terms of research quality, industry reputation, international outlook, research environment, and teaching. And then together, they put that together and it comes out with an overall score for each of the universities. Now, when it comes to the top 10 medical schools in the world, really important to know, only three countries are represented by that. They're either in Canada, the United States, or the United Kingdom. So starting at 10, the University of Pennsylvania. number 9 for that Canadian representation. We have the University of Toronto. So as much as it kills me to say it, thank you guys for putting us on that list. Number 8, we have the Yale University. 7, we have UCL in the United Kingdom. At 6, we have Johns Hopkins. At 5, we have Stanford. At 4, it's the Imperial College London. 3, we have the University of Cambridge. 2 is the Harvard University, sorry guys. And number 1 this year goes to the University of Oxford Medical School in the United Kingdom. So let's say you're shooting for one of these top universities, or let's say you're just trying to get into medical school. The reason why I partnered with MotivateMD for today is because I've come to the conclusion that as I now approach opening my own office in July, I'm gonna be working a little bit of rural merge as well. My schedule is just unbelievably crazy. Even to do videos like this takes so much time out of my day. And unfortunately, I don't have that time set aside right now to do one-on-one coaching anymore for people trying to get into medical school. So I do look for companies that are able to provide awesome services to students looking to get in, especially people that don't have any experience with the application process itself. Because as many of you know, there is a trick to the application process itself. And the more times you go through it, the higher your chance of success tends to be overall when you compare across different years. Now, one of the things that I like the most about MotivateMD is that they have custom packages for people with a 100% satisfaction guarantee. You could either choose to work with them just for your personal statement or your application as a whole or interview prep. And you could actually call and contact Becca, who's awesome. She's been great in terms of communicating with me. Her cell phone number will be listed in the link below, and you go ahead and reach out and give them a call. They'll set up a meeting with you, and they might ask you exactly what it is that you're looking for. And I think that's great to be able to offer a package specifically to whatever it is that you're interested in and an affordable and competitive rate. Now, the important part about all of this is that when you are getting help with your application, it has to be custom advice. Go ahead and use MotivateMD if you're interested, or find someone else, but make sure that that advice is tailored specifically to your application. And they've officially just launched their services for Canadian students as well, which is such a small market, and it's great that they're offering that too. So thanks guys for sponsoring the video. Now, for the final part of this video, I wanted to talk about what I think about all of this ranking stuff and my opinion as a doctor, someone that's made it to the end of this training process right now. And I think the short answer to all of this is that no, like I really don't think that this ranking stuff should really impact your decision at all in terms of where you're going to go in most cases. And I'll touch upon the exceptions as well. I'll say that someone actually put it best in the comment section of the last video that I did going over the Canadian school rankings. And that is that to a certain extent, the best medical school for you to go to is the one that you can actually get into. And it's become this joke in popular culture that medical school is so difficult to get into, but it's based on reality. When you look at the Canadian medical schools and their acceptance rates for getting in, even McMaster being 36 in the world or something like that. Well, let's just take a brief look. When you pull up the McMaster admission stats, you see that for the class of 2025, they received 5,605 applications. An average GPA was 3.91, and the overall acceptance rate was 3.6%. You could pull up U of T's admission stats, and you see a similar story. 4,263 applications, average GPA 3.93, overall acceptance very, very low. Now, just for the fun of it, I will put Harvard as well as Oxford's admission stats up on the screen as well, with their calculated acceptance rate overall. But just know for all of these universities on here, especially the top 50, it is statistically almost impossible to get in. So your goal as an applicant 90% of the time is to apply as broadly as possible, to structure your applications, your personal statements, practice a lot on your interviews too and your tactics for giving a proper interview, and try to get into hopefully as many different schools as possible, and then you get to pick which of those you actually want to based on a few of these different factors. Now, this is where the exception comes in. I'll say that if you know that you are a big researcher and that you are going to devote a lot of your career to the academic side and doing primary research as an MD, that's when I think you should actually put a little bit more attention into how the school's reputation is on a global sector, especially if you're going through the medical training program in Canada or the United States. Keep in mind that the matching process to residency is going to be the most important part. And residency is going to be actually where you build those skills for the rest of your career. Thankfully, my residency program was amazing and I felt that it really prepared me well. And I don't really think that it mattered too much what school that I went to, even though I really liked my school, But being here in this residency, there was a lot of rural exposure, a lot of procedural exposure, a lot of eMERGE, high acuity, and then office stuff and managing the office properly. I think the residency piece is the biggest part about this. So maybe looking into the different schools and how they match in terms of residency as well. But a lot of that is going to come down to you and being able to study for your board exams if you are an American student, being able to get a great score on the USMLE Step 2, and if you're a Canadian student, being able to pick your electives and choose and match properly. But it all comes down to what you're doing and not really so much as to where you're going. But anyways, everyone, that is going to be the video for today. I'm really curious what you think about all of this. Do rankings matter? Are you looking to go to a top-ranked school? And if so, why is that exactly? Or would you rather just go to an in-state school where you're gonna save a lot of money in tuition and set yourself up for your future career, and you could put that money towards opening your practice eventually, or whatever it is that you're doing? But anyways, if you wanna hear anything else from me, put it in the comment section below. We'll make more stuff about this in the future. Everyone have a great day, and we'll see you all in the next one.